After waiting for almost a year for her special needs infant to finally come home, Washington State mom Melinda Sayers' luck goes from bad to worse. Those motherly instincts better kick in.
She opened the bedroom door, looked out in the hall, saw a large fire in the living room.
Oh my God.
She saw a lot of thick black smoke, knew immediately it's abandoned ship time.
Come on, baby, we gotta go.
Opens the window, picks up the kid, puts the kid out the window, jumps out the window. Next thing she knows is she's waiting outside, the house blows.
The medical oxygen tank had exploded, and that's what she was hearing.
Yes, I need to report an emergency. There's a fire.
Thanks to Melinda's heroic actions, both mother and son are safe. But the home is severely damaged and in no condition for Abigail to come home. Melinda's sad and heroic tale instantly catches the media's attention.
The fire started earlier today at this home in Puyallup.
In the days that followed the fire, we saw her on the news several times. She described having lost everything.
When I saw the smoke, I knew we had to get out of there fast.
You really are a supermom. It was really frightening.
Amongst the media, she got this nickname of supermom.
And what about Abigail? We just want to bring our baby home.
Donations start to pour in.
Because of the news coverage, a lot of people with big hearts were willing to help this family out.
But the money doesn't heal the pain.
It's all my fault. I have no idea how to work an oxygen machine.
Oxygen in and of itself is not flammable, but it can certainly enhance any flame. And so what was in that area that had the capacity to be the start of this fire? The only thing we had was some children's toys.
Guess you gotta stop blaming yourself.
This could have been prevented. Abigail should be home with us.
Days after the fire, the Sayers file an insurance claim and find a new home.
They got a $5,000 advance from the insurance company and set up in some type of living quarters that the insurance company paid for.
Following protocol, Pierce County Deputy Fire Marshal Cole Roberts visits the damaged home to take a look around.
So where were you when the fire started?
Oh, I was in the bedroom with my son.
The fire marshal suspects this might be arson. And an inside job.
The lighter was on the couch in the same room as the oxygen tank that blew. Why is that sitting there, especially if you have a two-year-old running around the house?
So you could see the fire from here?
Yeah, I poked my head out and I could see the living room was on fire.
As we started looking at her description of how the fire started, it just wasn't conceivable that she could have seen what she claimed to have seen from that vantage point.
Nothing in Melinda's story adds up. And even worse, Melinda failed to tell the fire marshal about her past.
As we started to look into the background, we discovered that actually she had been a registered nurse.
And one that knows her way around an oxygen tank.
We knew that she had familiarity with medical oxygen.